first tools used by humans were often made with stones. Over a period of 3 million years, humans used a variety of stones a few different ways. One of the first ways was a process called flint knapping, where a piece of flint would be chipped and shaped into a sharp blade. Another method that was used was grinding stones down, crafting them into the desired shape or blade. So I met with Gil, an archaeologist at the University of Minnesota.
So I want to make some stone tools.
Starting 3.3 million years ago, humans were using cutting edges as their main way of interacting with the environment. So they would strike one stone with another. Hopefully the one that they're striking with does not break. Tend to be a harder stone, heterogeneous or crystalline rock, whereas the stone that they're striking would be homogeneous without a crystalline matrix in it. So when you insert a crack by striking it, the crack goes where you want it to. So you can control where the fracture happens. So flint knapping, the making of stone tools, is very much an intentional act. So this is what's called a hand axe or a biface. Two sides, two faces. This is, I think, what we should try to have you make, and also something that has somewhat of a dull back edge so that you can easily fit it in your hands. I learned how to flint knap barehanded, and that's good. You have much more control of the stone, but then again, you always do cut yourself, and so I figure we probably don't want to have blood on the screen. So there are certain rules to flint knapping in terms of the angles you have to follow. Mm-hmm. So if you want to break the stone, you need to strike one surface that is adjacent to an edge with another surface that is less than 90 degrees. So the angle of attack is from this direction to vertical, and from vertical this way you don't get the crack. So you want to have that type of direction. Learning how hard to hit is one of the big tricks in flint knapping, and it changes depending upon your stone. If you can try to make a biface or a hand axe for chopping down a tree, so I might want to think about this side being the place to grip, and then working this edge as an edge for fine working, and then maybe leaving this one slightly thicker if you wanted to do a more chopping gesture. So this is actually a caribou antler. Using antler allows you to make thinner flakes, essentially. So I'll start to flip it back and forth now to try to get a bifacial edge on it. We'll see if you can sort of hold it in your hand. I usually do it this way when I'm teaching people how to just hold it to begin with. Mm-hmm. Because you know where your own fingers are.
Yeah.
And so you can essentially aim for the tip of your pinky.
Okay.
And even if you hit your pinky, it's not really going to hurt you very much. But if it's underneath the stone, then you're hitting there. And you can think about it as a little round gesture.
Safety first.
Good.
That's getting there.
So maybe we'll start going this way again to bring the edge so we can kind of bring this up that way. Good, excellent.
Am I best off just using this by hand or?
Yeah, I think so. But this should, give you some cutting power.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, Gil, for showing me how to flint knap. Now I have a stone tool.